We were wondering if you have a minute to discuss some ideas that we had regarding the message.
I'm kind of 1 minute. I've got 1,000 things, but definitely 1 minute for you.
Okay, sir. So the idea is, I'll be quick. Aarti and Ayush came to me saying we'll make a video for Women's Day and include all our female faculty in it, giving their opinions and stuff.
Okay.
But then I think it's better coming from them. I'll let them explain.
So, sir, we were discussing how we can celebrate this time Women's Day, and we have come across the idea for shooting a video of all the faculty. And
so, sir, basically in that video, they will be giving their opinions. So that will not decide what kind of questions or not, that will be discussed.
Okay, I hope they have thought about it, because I always keep feeling them not to think, but then this time I will allow them to think. Okay, now.
But what do you think, sir? What kind of
maybe questions on women, their perspective. Let the
at least I invited our young faculty. Shivani, what do you think?
Sir, from a gender perspective, there are quite a few things that we can talk about. I think one of the major things is the way in which women are stereotyped at various places, within families, at workplaces, in the society in general. And incidentally, I came across this one thing where even the English language has multiple aspects where stereotyping is common. For example, if you look at the thesaurus, if you look at the similar words for feminine, the words that we find are dainty, delicate, tender. Whereas if you look at manly, we are finding words like strong and rugged and fearless, for that matter.
What about you, Amrita?
Yeah, if I may pitch in, I think just to continue, okay. I'm sorry to cut you. But I mean, what she's saying, especially profession, like even in our profession, especially in teaching, somehow people assume that women, it's an easier job, and you know, for a woman to be in, and women choose it especially because it's easy, or you know, if it's teaching, it's not for a male person to do, it's probably litigation or something that they should do. So I think professionally also there's a lot of stereotype in women choosing a career that's easier for them to do, which is not true at all. Like there are women in firms, there are women in litigation, there are women teaching, and they're all doing great jobs. So I think you know, that's bad stereotype that continues professionally also.
Amrita?
For me, I think if you talk about Women's Day specifically, the younger generation has to be addressed, specifically the young girls out there, with regard to being comfortable in their own skin and taking chances and risk in their lives. They should not be put into one box, which the society demands, definitely. They should move out of that and do what they like to do.
Great.
But why only one day?
Not.
And this, why celebrate only one day in a year? Why shouldn't it be every day? Why shouldn't we imbibe it in our daily life?
So because a journey of 1,000 miles starts with a single step. So if not every day that we are doing this, let's at least start off with one day at a time.
Fair enough. Okay, fine. What are the, so how do you plan to take it forward? How?
We thought we'll have somebody ask questions to all the, you know, female faculty on this and a couple of other issues maybe.
Okay. Let me see who's there. There's only one left. Anish. Hello. Call Anish, no? Good, Anish, see what they have planned is they have kind of have an event plan for the Women's Day. So it's kind of asking questions and they answer. So we thought you're the right person to fit into that role and ask questions. Of course, general questions which the women will answer.
But this is for the celebration of Women's Day.
True.
Great. Then I do have a couple of questions in mind. Hmm. But then, having said that, thank you for this, sir. I think because we celebrate a lot of women's stories, so this is our chance to celebrate their womanlyhood as well. So let's rejoice in the womanhood.
Great.
I have a couple of questions, and that is with regard to how they have managed their work life, especially during COVID times. I have formed a lot of answers, but I'll be very curious to know what our colleagues have to say on.
If your workplace compels you to follow gender stereotype, will you be comfortable? I would definitely say no to it. I wouldn't be happy. Particularly, I work in an educational institution where there is no work which can be gender biased. There is no work, there is no activity which is happening here which can be gender biased. And on this Women's Day, what I would like to tell every woman in this world is let strength and honor be your clothing. And I'm sure you look at the future and smile at it. Thank you. I will definitely not be comfortable. This is the change that we need to bring in, as we women should look ourselves from our perspective, a women's perspective, but we are used to look at ourselves from a man's perspective. This is the change, and we need to choose the challenge to bring out that change, not to be a part of it. And I request all the women out there to come out of that gender identity and stop looking ourselves from man's world or man's perspective. Thank you. Happy International Women's Day.
Generally, I don't prefer with stereotype working, because technology generally means to men. Here we have broken out. Major people, women's are supporting to the tech team, and it is already broken out, and it should not exist anymore.
Do you feel you enjoy a more sense of security working in an educational sector in comparison to other sectors?
Yes, educational sector is more convenient as to time as well as comfort. With young minds, every day we are working and enjoying the youthfulness. Because of that, it's very stress-free than other sectors.
How difficult has been to attain the work-life balance, especially during the COVID times?
Firstly, there was so much of panic on a personal side. And when coming to professional life, from a class full of students, we had walked into an online classes, which initially was quite difficult where we were concerned, because we had to look into a laptop screen and talk to the students. At a personal front also, we were so much scared, like what will happen if you're going out and meeting people. But then at the end of the day, you need to manage both. Slowly we get used to the technology, we get more and more ideas as to how to teach online. And then I think we very well managed the pandemic.
Yeah, as a woman, we are strongest. You're born as a strong woman. We try to balance between the work and the household work also. That way you could justify both the side.
People will say that COVID situation has not strengthened and has given a much more difficulty for women folk. But in my opinion, it's very wrong. Because we learned a lot of things, and balancing between a family and taking care of the family simultaneously and going on with our own profession, it was much hectic, but still we learned a lot, and we are now very confident that we can face any of the risk, even whatever it is going to come in near future. Thank you so much, Dios.
Online and offline classes both have unique characteristics that makes them worthwhile. People have to learn two together. However, when debate comes one over the other, the truth lies that online teaching can never replace offline, that is in-campus learning. Happy Women's Day to all beautiful women who are working in this institution. All of us know that we are the one who make office environment cheerful. Without us, nothing is blissful. Enjoy every day. Celebrate every day as Women's Day. Happy Women's Day.
Considering the kind of controversies which the hashtag MeToo movement quoted, would you still support the women's right in the workplace?
Obviously, there's no doubt about it at all. Yes, women are vulnerable and they are put into a lot of hardship. Nevertheless, as I'm very popularly called, I'm the male chauvinist in a sari. So I do want the men to be equally protected, because I don't want the fact to be rubbed in that you are weak, so I'm giving you this right. I am very powerful, and I like that. I like it that way.
Every law is likely to be abused, whether it is with respect to dowry harassment or whether it is the Me Too movement. Now, merely because some people are misusing it does not mean you need to classify the entire group as people who misuse the law. Sexual harassment at workplace happens everywhere. It's prevalent in every organization. It could be as simple as passing innuendos which are supposed to be considered as jokes, or it could be full-fledged molestations. In this regard, in order to protect the people who are likely to be victims, this law is necessary, irrespective of who is abusing this and how often it is abused.
Well, Anish, what's the situation? Where are we now?
So, but done with the session, with the session which was filled with goodness and warmth.
Okay.
So finally, it's done.
All the answers are in.
Yes.
All the women have spoken.
Absolutely, sir.
Great, great. But why does it feel a little inadequate then?
I did have that sense as well, but I'm unable to recollect as to what I'm missing here.
Ah, I think I got it. I think we missed a message by
Dean,
sir.
True, sir. True, so true.
Yeah.
True. Very true.
Let's
yes.
do it then.
Absolutely.
Let's go record Dean, sir.
Yes, sir. Very much.
Come on.
Thank you.
Women through the ages have been respected, and they are respected even in India. They are equal to men and gifted with equal mental capacities. They are found in every sphere of life, and they have contributed much to the growth of India and the world.